Morning world, Zippy Trev here. It's a bloody windy one this morning. Roll the intro.
Hi, Zippy Trev here, and welcome to my channel. Hope you get something out of it.
Rightio world, so as if you watched my last video about the mail call today, thank you Robbo yet again, brilliant, and also thank you Kat. Bike hasn't been started for 2 weeks, so this will be interesting. Carby must drain down while she sits. So I've got a total of 82 miles on the clock. Childers and back's about 60 mile round trip, so that'll put me at 140 miles on the clock. I'm hoping that's enough to get me there and back without hitting reserve. I don't know if this bike loses fuel while it's sitting around or anything, so I could be rolling back in on vapors. It's like I did come back from Mount Morgan in the boat. Oh my God. Literally rolled into, that was a frustrating drive. Maybe just a bit of a warm up. Come back from Mount Morgan, and I was about 20 out from Gander, and the fuel gauge is looking rather empty, and I'd already clocked my 300 miles thereabouts. Clutch is still good. And I've been 10k's out of Gander, hanging to get to a petrol station because I didn't know what my miles on the boat was. And coming out of Mundubbera, and there was this big downcline, and up in front I had a caravan in four-wheel drive in front of me, and in front of me the four-wheel drive there was this big cattle road train, and he was huge, and he come down that mountain in first gear. Long trip down the mountain, there was no way past. I almost thought about scooting around on the inside, and I'm just thinking, holy shit, I just got to make the servo. That's all I got to do. I've just got to make the servo, and I'll be happy. And I did. 7 litres in the tank, so she was getting down all right. She was on vapors. Fuck, it's windy today. Not overly warm, I haven't got my leather jacket on, so hopefully I won't be needing that by the time I get back. By the time I get back, it's too fucking late, isn't it? So I was also watching Angel Red Rider this morning. Taking out an Indian for a test ride, a brand new one. And she was running a JC bike, the road bike. Aussie built road mine, so that was good to see. She had a mic coming around onto her face. I've tried doing that on this. Oh, sorry, I've tried doing that with my road mic, JC mic, but I also got a horrible fucking feedback, so. I know you're bloody complaining about my audio. I'm not working on both speakers. Basically, you're going to always get wind noise. grass and shit from the... Oh, God, there's something coming off the road. They've been slashing.
Let's go. Next one.
hair back about me rear tyre that's been on order for over 3 weeks now, probably 4 weeks now. I still haven't heard what's going on, if that's where that is. I guess I'm lucky it's winter right now and I don't have any, well, it's not winter, but we're about to come into winter, so I don't have any big trips planned. I have maybe 500 miles left on the back tyre, I'm not sure. I should probably head up to the children's bike shop and ask them what's going on. Neutral then. Righto, worlds. I'll be back shortly. Righto, worlds. No paint pens. Spewing. I have to try and buy them online. All right. Let's go and see if we can find this naughty shop down here. If not, I'll head to the supery. after I spotted it down here. Few bikes around. I'm pretty sure that's up here. It's up here on the accessories normally. My clutches are not working quite the way I thought it should. Rightio, I'm going to go and see if I can get what I want. Rightio, well, so yet again, another tobacconist that doesn't sell bloody cigars. Fuck. That's, the tobacconist over in Scarborough that does. I spent a day over in Bundy when I had the extractors fitted, not fitted to the boat, and I went through five actual tobacconists in Bundy, through the whole main street and around. Not one of them sold cigars. And the only place I can get them either is here, in Childers at the local supery, or it's to run over to Scarborough and to the tobacconist there. So, call yourself a tobacconist. You don't sell cigars. I think my clutch needs readjusting. Something doesn't look good. No. So now I can get them here. So, right, our worlds. I'll catch you on the way out. Technology. Got a YouTube channel, mate.
Oh, do you?
Yeah. If you're into YouTube, check it out. Hippie Trev.
What's your name? Hippie Trev.
Hippie Trev.
No worries, mate.
Got everything I wanted and one little bit extra, so I got me naughty sticks, which is all good, and there was a little just cheap $2 shop there, so I walked in and they had some paint pens there, so that was really good too, so I'll be getting into them with on my models later today. Chilly enough to be wearing a leather jacket. Oh, I'm getting too fat. What the? This leather vest on me is tight as. Shit, I'm getting way too fat. Alright, I'm gonna get rid of this pot belly I got. Not like I eat much. I drink more cup of tea than I have food. Either. Turn it off. up in the mail. It's absolutely amazing. People's generosity blow me away. It does. Very much so.
another very uneventful ride. Must have been very boring to you guys. Hey, I don't mind that eventful. We hit reserve at 1:33 on the clock, which is a bit normal and usual. I can't remember what the last ride I did was over the Childers. And I think I rode it pretty hard, but when this bike seems to sit for a long period of time, it does seem to lose fuel out of the tank. Now, that's a hard trip. Now, what's going on with this car here? Is this guy all right, or...?
Bonnet's up.
By the coppers, and he's just left the bonnet up so everyone thinks he's broken down, or he's actually genuinely broken down. So, as I was saying, yes, a very, very uneventful ride over and back, but we like that. The only thing that really happened was I hit reserve, that was it. Oh, look at this fucking clown, he just...
rougher and harder when things are cold. So I could have almost worn my leather jacket over today, but I'm still glad I didn't. I'm now nice and warm. Now I'm back in town, I'm nice and warm again. Now, I've been sober for a week, literally.
Manual that Simon sent me.
Actually, I'll leave that there. We're on our welds. We'll be back in a minute. We're back. Got me bottle of Jack's. Yeah, this crutch is a bit... Oh, shit. I'm on reserve. Got to remember that. This crutch is a little bit weird. I hope there's nothing going on that I'm unaware of. It doesn't slip or anything. Something's not right with this clutch.
And mark that cutting. Okay, found neutral then, pretty easy, so.
the bike is running good, no doubt about that. The bike's just purring, actually. Feels really good. Maybe that's it, I had the oil up too high, so. Rightio Worlds, we've got 142 mile on the clock. We hit reserve at 133 miles. That was way earlier than it should have. I think that's just from being sitting around for 2 weeks. I think it just devaps fuel out of here. So anyway, successful mission. So yeah, the tobacconist doesn't sell naughty sticks. The cheap shop up there didn't have the paint pens, but then I went to the cheap shop down near the supermarket and I scored some really, what looked to be really good paint pens. And on that, a very uneventful ride home. The wind seems to have pissed off and I think we're in for a nice afternoon. And it was really good to get back out on the bike. Riding Ruby Paul, yeah, mate, it was good to get back out on the bike again. Look, I know that this ride's probably getting boring to you guys, but you know what, a ride's a ride round here. When you live in a small town and there's only sort of like two or three roads going either direction, that's pretty much the choice you have. And I normally only get on the bike when I have a mission. So anyway, Worlds, stay safe, keep your knees in the breeze, and we'll catch you later. Bye.